Most people in life are looking for how do I make a life worth living and a retirement with saving that is safe for our personal families. Our personal families are the people that we go off and create a betrothal to. Our personal families are the people that we go off and put our money and our time and our investments into. Our personal families are those people that are the ones we sleep with, the ones we play with, the ones we travel with, the ones that we stay with, and that is our personal family. Any person that we might be related to outside of that concept are simply relatives, mere blood relatives perhaps, but your relationship with your blood relatives is completely on your ass. Your stupidity in life is not recognizing where your boundaries begin and end in life. You may have an opinion about a relative that you're related to, but you don't have the right to give them any strife. And every time you do, put yourself in legal land. Legal land because there are laws across America that protect our rights. They protect our rights to privacy, they protect our genitalia, they protect our medical rights, they protect our telephone rights, they protect our telecommunications rights because we use social media across telephone lines, and we learned during the Nixon era that no one has a right to penetrate those rights. We have mobility rights, we have travel rights, we have freedom rights, and those are the whole point of our United States Constitution. They're the whole point of the civil rights movement. They're the whole point of the black versus white versus color versus red versus yellow versus whatever the fuck it is, relations of the nation. You see, we are not a melting pot. People are not willing to melt in together with their ideologies and their networks and their social skills. What I see them doing all over campuses across America, a million fucking imported students, what the fuck are they doing here? They are going to take their technology that they learned from us and take it back home? I don't think so. I think they came here to play here, to lay here, to stay here, to fuck us over. But that's my opinion as a white supremacist. Now, am I truly a white supremacist? Not really. Should I become a white supremacist? No. Do I feel white supremacist tendencies? Of course I do, just like every other fucking ethnic group on the planet. Black Lives Matter is a totally ethnocentric program. It basically says that only black lives matter, that they don't have to regard their heritage of what Martin Luther King or Rosa Parks did for the rest of the land, and not only for their own communities, but how it impacted everyone's hands. You see, this is the entitlement factor, that there are young blacks in their 18 through 20 who think they have the right to piss all over a white man because of this Black Lives Matter campaign. They humiliate themselves with their mouths and their foulness of their mouth and calling everybody bitch every time. They walk up to a white man and call him a bitch. They allow these white maintenance men who have no fucking future because they failed their lives and they put themselves in a $10 to $12 an hour job, and that's the end of it for them. And these fuckers think they have the right to power over someone with intelligence. So they put their little networks together, they stalk them under federal law, breaking the law, and they get away with it because police officers let them do it all. Now, how am I doing? Then we've got the Muslims who come here, who put their fucking hands on us in the night, steal our property, cut our beards like the Mexicans do in the night, and they think they're ninjas of some kind. You're not. You're here illegally, you're here immorally, you're being worked in our restaurants, worked in our construction, and you're allowed to sit there and keep fucking talking Mexican when this is America, and one of the requirements of American citizenship is fluency is in the Lord's mouth, or English, as we call it today. So don't give me any fucking play that you're here legally if you can't speak the fucking words of your mouth. Now, my spouse, my late significant other, and my son, who was also of a foreign-born nation, knew how to speak the Lord's English. They proved themselves on international tests to come here. They literally proved themselves when they got here, and I paid through the nose to make sure they had education. Nobody in my fucking family, siblings, had paid for that. Nobody helped me do any of that. And they can go fuck themselves if they think they're going to talk about my late spouse as if they have rights to it when they literally treated her like a fucking mouse. They treated her as a maid. They treated her as a next to nothing. She never got accolades in my father's obituary. Who the fuck do you think you are dismissing my late spouse, my late wife, my late child, making them some special entity to me? You motherfuckers are the liars of America, and I will not tolerate your shit. But don't you fucking try to tell me about my life, you little fucking twit, because you've never been a part of my life. Your bastard husband's destroyed our family. Your selfish bastard husband doesn't do anything for his own motherfucking father and mother who are living in poverty. So don't you fucking talk to me about what you think of God to me. Because your God is not the same as my God, or your version of the real God is not the same version of my God, because my God's a loving God. My God's a peace-oriented God. My God knows that God has created the diversity of the world for a lot of reasons, but my God did not create the perversity of the world that you promote in your mouth. When you think you have rights to talk about someone's private body parts that are not your right to talk about.